Hello friends, I am Neha and I am back with the current affairs for today, that is August 31st, 2019. So as you can see that there are two blocks. First is National Sports Day and second is Fit India Movement. So we will be talking about a lot of exciting news in this morning tale. So stay tuned till the end. So recently, that is on August 29, we have celebrated the National Sports Day. And on the occasion of National Sports Day, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has launched a new movement which is called Fit India Movement. So now, as the name itself is suggesting, that the movement aims to make India fit. So keeping in view this objective, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has launched this movement in order to encourage people to inculcate exercises and a healthy lifestyle in their lives. So do remember these two things, that National Sports Day is observed on 29 August, and on this occasion this Fit India Movement has been launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in association with Ministry of Sports. So now guys, the task for you is that you have to tell me that who is the Minister of Sports right now. Okay, and now let's begin our morning tales. The first question is, what is the name of the portal launched by Ministry of HRD to integrate various education portals to bring transparency in education system? So this is quite important, that Ministry of HRD has recently launched a portal which is an integrated platform to link all the education portals. And what is the aim behind launching this? It is aimed at bringing transparency in the education system. So now, what is the name of that portal? The portal is named as Shagun. So this is the name of the portal. And in this portal, a feedback procedure for the parents has also been embedded. So basically now the parents can also give their feedback about the education system, as well as they can also gather information about the education system in India. So that is all about this new portal, but do remember the name of this portal. And I have a question for you guys. Now you have to tell me that who is the Minister of HRD. Next question for today is, which city is ranked first at the Safe Cities Index 2019 released by Economist Intelligence Unit? So basically, recently this Economist Intelligence Unit has released a Safe Cities Index. And in this index, it has mentioned that Tokyo is the safest city in the world. And now, what is the rank of India in this index, or does any Indian city have a place in this index? So these are the questions which must be coming up in your mind. So let me answer these questions while zooming out on this picture. So friends, there are two cities from India which have found a place in this index, and these two cities are Delhi and Mumbai. So Delhi has been ranked at 52nd position and Mumbai has been ranked at 45th position. And this is the overall global position of these two cities. This index measures 60 countries across 5 continents on the basis of 4 parameters, and those 4 parameters are digital security, health security, infra security and personal security. Now friends, as we can see that there are different lists or rankings for all these parameters, but the thing which we need to consider here is the overall ranking. So do keep in mind the overall ranking. So which country is the worst or is the most unsafe city? It is Lagos. And where does this city fall? So this city is situated in Nigeria. So this Nigerian city is the world's most unsafe city, and Tokyo, which is in Japan, is the safest city. So this is our third question. Who has become the first Indian to complete the 555 kilometers long La Ultra, the high marathon in Ladakh? So the first information which we have gathered from the question is that this La Ultra, the high marathon, was held in Ladakh, and this marathon has been completed by Ashish Kasudekar. So he has become the first Indian to complete this 555 kilometer long marathon. And now it's time to move on to the next question, which is, who has won the Kalinga FCC Awards for Excellence in Journalism for 2019 in the category of Television Journalist of the Year? So basically, why are these awards so important? This award is important for us because this is the first of its kind in India award given by Kalinga and FCC. So a little more about the background of this award, and then we will be discussing about the answer. So basically, in the month of February 2019, Foreign Correspondents Club of South Asia and Kalinga Institute of Industrial Technology, that is located in Bhubaneswar, they both have signed an MOU to institute this journalist award. So this is the first edition of this award. Now the answer to this question is option A, Rajni Vaidyanathan. So now an interesting fact about Vaidyanathan is that she has been awarded this award for her coverage on Me Too in Bollywood. Now this award is given in 5 categories, and these 5 categories are Print Journalist of the Year, Television Journalist of the Year, Video Journalist of the Year, Photo Journalist of the Year, and Digital Journalist of the Year. Now why is it important to remember all these 5 categories? Because as I mentioned that this is the first edition of this award, so there are high chances that it can be asked in the examination. Now this print media or this print journalist of the year award has been given to a 9-member team of Reuters. So it is a news wire. And this television journalist of the year, we have already discussed. Video journalist of the year award has been given to Rakesh Nagar. And he has been given this award for his documentary, Music in the Mountains. Now, he belongs to PBS News Hours. And Rajni Vaidyanathan belonged to BBC News Channel. Photo journalist of the year award has been given to Harish Tyagi. And he is from EPA. And the digital journalist of the year has been awarded to a team of 8 members, again from the channel of Reuters. So this year Reuters has bagged 2 awards. First is in the category of print media and second is in the category of digital media. And now let's move on to the next question. Which state has got the GI tag for Dindigul lock and Kandangi sari? So these 2 products have been given geographical indication tag very recently, and Tamil Nadu has got the GI tag for producing both these products. What is the currency of Gambia? Now why is this question here? So the reason behind putting this question here is that recently President of India, that is Ramnath Kovind, has visited 3 nations in Africa. So the 3 nations were Gambia, Benin and Guinea. And we have already discussed about his tour in one of our previous morning tales, so I will not be discussing about the details here. But yes, a question can be framed on it in the examination, so this is important. Now what is the currency of Gambia? So it is option E, Dalasi. Gambian Dalasi is the currency of Gambia. Which decade has been declared as the UN decade of family farming? So this is important that United Nations designate a whole decade or whole pack of 10 years for a purpose, and the purpose is family farming. So what is family farming? As the name itself is suggesting, that family farming refers to the farming primarily by the family members. So this UN decade of family farming has been designated by FAO, that is Food and Agricultural Organization of UN, and the year or the decade is 2019 to 2028, as the picture is also indicating. So now guys, the task for you is that you have to mention the headquarters of FAO in the comment section below. Next question is, where is Kishtwar National Park located? So there are 5 options: Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Uttarakhand and Jammu and Kashmir. So out of these 5 options, it is option E, Jammu and Kashmir, where is this beautiful national park is located. So I am coming up with the national parks and wildlife sanctuaries in Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh nowadays, because since Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh is in the news, so there are high chances that these questions can be framed in the examination. Where is Simlipal National Park located? Again, we have 5 options: Odisha, Telangana, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala. And out of these 5 options, it is option A, Odisha, where this national park cum tiger reserve is located. Where is the headquarters of Worldwide Fund? So the headquarters of the Worldwide Fund is located in Switzerland at Gland City. And now the task for you is that you have to tell me that who is the head of this organization, that is Worldwide Fund. And now it's time to conclude our morning tales for today. And thank you so much guys for watching our video. And also, if you have liked our video, so do not forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for all the latest notifications. Thank you so much.